my wife's family, that's people who are called the Purdy's, have successfully traced their ancestry the whole way back to 1588. They are here because they are descendants of the survivors of the Girona shipwreck. Well, I won't do that. What I will do is keep it simple, the way I was taught. The Giant's Causeway, folks, is 66 million years old. And it came about at the end of the Jurassic period, when a huge meteorite storm crashed into the Earth, causing huge devastation and change. The two most noticeable, number one, the end of the time of the dinosaur, the end of the Jurassic period. Secondly, Earth moved out of a tropical climate into an ice age. And imagine this, at its very worst, there would have been another 3 kilometres of thick packed ice up the top of these cliffs. So Earth was a very different place. Now, because so much happened above the surface of the Earth, equally a lot happened below the surface, where in the mantles of the Earth you would find huge masses known as tectonic plates. Anybody ever heard of those? Thankfully. Well, all those millennia ago, there would have been two plates below your feet, the North American plate and the Eurasian plate. But because of this melting pot of pressure below them, they began to move, to pull apart, to form new continents. At the origin of that movement, it tore open the Earth's surface, creating tears which we know as fissures. Now, it was through fissures then that this hot molten lava was released and flowed out. Notice that terminology, folks, because there never ever was a volcano in this site, but there was volcanic activity. Now, when something flows, very naturally, it makes its way downhill, would you agree? Well, look around you. Look where you're actually standing at right now. You're right down in the bottom of a bowl, of a basin, a river basin. And when you see those columns, in those days, this was the riverbed. So imagine this hot molten lava flows downhill, chases out the water that lay in this area and replaces that water. It fills that void and basically it becomes a lake here in its own right. And now from 1100 degrees Celsius, this lake begins to cool. But bear this in mind, in those days the ocean was 4 kilometres off the shoreline. So as the mass there begins to cool and harden and solidify, a further lava flow occurs and it rests on the top of this layer. Look straight across the top of the stones, you'll see very clearly the evidence of that. This layer here becomes trapped. That's vitally important. That affords the opportunity to cool evenly over a prolonged period without being disturbed. Now relatively quickly it begins to form and take shape because as it cools it reduces in size. That causes the mass to contract. The pressure of the contraction causes the mass to crack. The cracks emanate from heat spots across the surface. They are very easy to describe. They look like the letter Y. Look behind me. Look into these stones. Find for yourselves a letter Y. Now watch. Look at the lines as they travel. They unite, they combine. The patterns are being formed. Hexagons and polygons are being developed. That's happened across its top surface, at the same time as happened below. And now with more contraction comes more cracks, but this time they're vertical. They're travelling towards the centre, they're trying to find the heat. Here they combine and form columns. So basically at that stage what we had trapped here was a perfect rock formation. That's exactly how it stayed, until the end of that ice age. When, via velocity, these glaciers fell over these hillsides and swept through this valley. Very unevenly